Hello, welcome everybody. This is Dr. Bolad, board certified physician in cardiology, interventional cardiology, and internal medicine. I am here to help you with all the information you need for your heart health and general health, and informing you about all the latest treatments in cardiology and medicine. If you are new to this channel, then definitely consider hitting the subscribe button below and switch on the notification bell so you don't miss any new videos that I post. For my international viewers outside the United States, you can get translated subtitles for this video by pressing the closed caption CC button on the upper right part of your mobile device screen and selecting your preferred language from the settings. I get asked regularly by my patients, is coffee bad for my heart? My answer to them is absolutely not. Coffee is actually good for your heart. Caffeine is the most widely used pharmacologically active substance in the world. It's consumed in coffee, tea, and soft drinks, and the prevalence of exposure is very high, more than 80% in most countries. Coffee averages 100 mg of caffeine per serving, colas about 50 mg per serving, and energy drinks as much as 250 mg per serving. Here is the amount of caffeine in the different types of coffees and other caffeinated drinks, generally measured in 8-ounce cups. This is the cup size of the one shown on the right-hand side of the screen. Most of the relevant studies of chronic caffeine ingestion has been performed in coffee drinkers, and thus I will concentrate on the effects of coffee that has on the cardiovascular system in this video. While coffee contains other compounds such as chlorogenic acid, potassium, magnesium, niacin, lignans, these compounds have not been shown to influence cardiovascular outcomes in the amounts consumed by coffee drinkers. Caffeine is a methylated xanthine derivative, and its effect on cardiovascular hemodynamics as well as electrophysiological properties of the heart are noted. A number of molecular mechanisms have been detected in vitro for methyl xanthines, but only some that take place at reasonably low concentrations are involved in the response observed in the body. I will now discuss the specific concerns on the effects of coffee and caffeine on the heart. Arrhythmias, meaning irregularity of heart beating. Despite the theoretical relationship between caffeine and arrhythmias, the available clinical evidence suggests that caffeine in doses typically consumed, that's to say, up to 400 milligrams per day, which is roughly equivalent to 5 cups of coffee, does not provoke arrhythmias. There has been 2 small studies that showed caffeine causes arrhythmias, but this has not been substantiated in large observational or prospective studies. Nevertheless, there are patients who may be more sensitive to caffeine and note a relationship of palpitations to coffee and caffeine intake. Heart rate variability has been examined in a number of studies among habitual consumers of caffeine and coffee. In a systematic review of 12 trials that evaluated the effect of 400 to 500 mg of caffeine per day, there was not a consistent relationship with heart rate variability. The evidence as a whole supports the notion that 400 mg of caffeine per day in healthy adults is not associated with increase in heart rate variability. Blood pressure. There is little or no acute effect of caffeine on the blood pressure of habitual coffee drinkers, although caffeine can acutely raise the blood pressure by as much as 10 mm in individuals who do not drink coffee regularly. One systematic review and meta-analysis of 10 randomized controlled trials and 5 cohort studies found no effect of chronic coffee consumption on blood pressure and the risk of developing hypertension. However, 2 other meta-analyses found that coffee ingestion increased blood pressure slightly. Consistent with this observation is that similar reduction in blood pressure has been seen when habitual coffee drinkers either abstain from coffee or switch to decaffeinated coffee. Diuretic effect. Caffeine in higher doses may have a diuretic effect, acting like the water pill that are designed to increase the amount of water and salt expelled from the body as urine. One review suggested that acute ingestion of caffeine in doses of at least 250 to 300 mg, equivalent to amounts found in 2 to 3 cups of coffee, results in short-term stimulation of urine output in individuals deprived of caffeine for a period of days or weeks. For regular coffee drinkers, a tolerance to the diuretic effect develops and diuresis is diminished in those who regularly consume coffee. Aortic stiffness. The aorta is the main artery that carries blood from the heart and distributes the blood through branches to the rest of the body. Aortic stiffness is an important determinant of the performance of the cardiovascular system and prognosis of the cardiovascular risk. Caffeine acutely increases arterial stiffness, and the effect is synergistic with smoking. Lipids. There is no major impact of filtered coffee consumption on the lipid profile. Most studies have shown no adverse effect of filtered coffee intake on plasma lipids. In the prospective cohort study of over 132,000 men and women from the Health Professionals Follow-up Study and the Nurses Health Study, there was no association between the intake of filtered caffeinated coffee or filtered decaffeinated coffee and serum concentrations of total cholesterol, low-density lipoprotein cholesterol, or high-density lipoprotein cholesterol. However, there may be a hyperlipidemic effect of non-filtered coffee which contains coffee lipid compounds, such as caffeostol, that are not removed by a paper filter. Cardiovascular disease incidence. There appears to be no adverse impact of caffeine or caffeinated beverage consumption on cardiovascular disease risk based on many large observational studies. A 2014 meta-analysis of 36 prospective cohort studies, which included nearly 1.3 million individuals, evaluated the relationship between coffee consumption and cardiovascular disease risk, a composite of coronary heart disease, stroke, heart failure, and cardiovascular disease mortality, and found that compared with individuals who consume no coffee, the relative risk of cardiovascular disease was slightly less in coffee drinkers. Stroke prevention. Coffee consumption has been associated with a lower incidence of stroke. In a prospective cohort study of male smokers from Finland with a mean follow-up of 13.5 years, high consumption of coffee was associated with a lower risk of cerebral infarction independent of known cardiovascular risk factors. Deaths. Most but not all observational studies have found an inverse relationship between coffee consumption and all-cause death and cardiovascular death. These findings have been noted in many different racial and ethnic groups. So, my key points on the effects of caffeine and coffee on the heart is that caffeine is the most widely used pharmacologically active substance in the world, consumed in coffee, tea, soft drinks, and small amounts also are in chocolate. Coffee in doses typically consumed does not provoke arrhythmias, and its routine use in patients who have or at risk of arrhythmias is acceptable. Coffee consumption does not have a major impact on the lipid profile. It is possible that there is a slight increase in blood pressure with chronic coffee use. Small or moderate amounts of 6 or less 8-ounce cups of coffee per day does not increase death or stroke, and this is supported by scientific studies. If you have any question about what I presented to you today or any medical question in general, then subscribe to my channel and share your question in the comment section below and I will reply to you. If you have a question that you would not like to share in public, then subscribe to this channel, follow me on Twitter at Dr. Bolad, and then send me a private Twitter direct message and I will reply to you. Please like and share this video with family and friends. This is Dr. Bolad, helping you with your heart health. Thanks for watching and talk to you soon.